The drag and drop behavior gives you the ability to drag and drop items on the screen with a mouse click or touch event. Let's take a look at how it works. Dragging and dropping an object is something that's very common when creating a game, and with the drag and drop behavior, you can easily add this functionality to your Construct 2 game. I have a layout set up here with some different trees. I've gone ahead and added the drag and drop behavior to each of these trees. If I select one of the apple trees, we can see its properties over here on the left side. The drag and drop behavior has two properties, axes and initial state. Initial state just determines whether or not the drag and drop behavior is active at the start of the layout. You could enable drag and drop later, after the player accomplishes a certain objective, or you could have drag and drop enabled from the start of the layout. The other option, axes, lets you determine the axes that the object can be dragged upon. The default, which each of these apple trees are set to, is for the object to be draggable on both axes, up and down, and left and right. I've set the orange trees to move only on the horizontal axis, while the lemon trees are draggable on the vertical axis. Let's take a look. First, if I click and drag the apple tree, I can move it up and down, or left and right. I can place it anywhere. But the orange tree is only draggable on the horizontal axis. I can move it left or right, but not up or down. The lemon tree is the opposite. I can drag it on the vertical axis, up and down, but not left or right. I have an object here, LED, which is like a little green LED that I'll use to show some of the events associated with the drag and drop behavior. This LED has two single frame animations, off and on. If I switch to the event sheet and select Add Event, I can add an event using the tree object. If I scroll down to the drag and drop events, we have four options: Is Dragging, Is Enabled, On Drag Start, and On Drop. Is Enabled will return true if the behavior is enabled. If I select Is Enabled, then I'll add an action and choose the LED, and then select Set Animation, I'll switch it to the On animation. So, if the tree has drag and drop enabled, the LED's animation will be set to On. Okay, the tree's drag and drop behavior is enabled at the start of the layout, so the LED is on. I'm going to replace that event with the isDragging event. Now, if I'm dragging the tree object, this event will return true, and the LED's animation will be set to on. I'll add another event on the tree, but this time I'll choose onDrop. Then I'll add an action with the LED object, and I'll set the animation to off. Now, if I drag the apple tree, the LED turns on, and when I drop the tree, the LED turns back off. What's happening is, every frame that the tree object is being dragged, it will set the animation of the LED to on, and when the tree object is dropped, it sets the LED to off. It works fine, but there is a problem. Of course, efficiency doesn't matter in a small demo like this, but if you guys did this the same way in a game, it would be inefficient. So let's take a look at why. When the LED is turned off by the onDrop event, that is a single event, fired off one time, just when you drop the object. But the isDragging event is firing off every frame. That means if my frame rate is 60 frames per second, then the LED is having its animation set to on 60 times per second. There's a more efficient way to handle this, and that's by using onDragStart. OnDragStart will fire off one time, just when you start dragging the tree. The LED will have its animation set to on one time, and no other events will occur until the onDrop event. Now, this doesn't mean that the isDragging event itself is inefficient, just that in this situation it would be. isDragging should only be used if you need to update something each frame that the object is being dragged. If you only need to update something once, like this animation, use the onDragStart event instead. Thanks for watching. If you found this content helpful, please consider supporting me on Patreon. Comment, like and share this video, and subscribe for more tutorials. See you next time.